concerning health. This is for the health department, Rastafari Foundation. This is probably like the best knowledge that we could share, contribute with the peoples of Rastafari concerning health. Now, New Testament, we find individuals that know that if only they could just touch the end, the corner, the edge of the garment worn by Jesus the Christ, that by doing so they would become whole, that they would become that they would be freed from the burdens of the diseases or discomforts that are at that time upon them. If only they could touch the fringe of the garments of the Son of the Living God, Jesus Christos, that they would be made whole. So what we're trying to say is that these individuals had a love can be often misinterpreted or imagined to be something else, but rather what is love as we are to define it in this particular message. Love is desire, the want, the wishing for, hoping for, striving for, in hopes of, you know, after something. So the desire, and we know by scripture, through scripture, in scripture, that the greatest commandment is to love the Lord our God, the Most High Himself, with all our heart, mind, soul, and strength. So that is to desire, to look for Him. So these individuals sought Jesus. They sought the manifestation of the Word. They desired, and they are seeking, and surely they knew that if only they could attain or grasp, even if just a little bit, even if just the outer edge or the fringe of His garment, that surely they would be made whole. And that is exactly what would come to pass. They got it. They got a little of that which was necessary to be whole and lack nothing. Their want of that which is whole brought holiness to themselves and rid them of any dis-ease, discomfort, and all that does not pertain to the man, to man created in the image of His Creator. And by man, we mean men, women, and children. So now, where we're trying to get to this with is who is Jesus Christos? He is the manifestation of the Word in the flesh. So in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God, is and will always be God. So now if we kind of focus on the word, but the Greek word for that is logos, but we're actually going to incline towards the Latin, which is the ratio, or regia, the rationale, the reason, the grounds for judgment, we could say. So the reason why. Jesus is the reason why for all things. But if we could apply this to our health, then we are surely to fulfill that which is lacking and become one, holy, and thus perfect. For the Almighty Creator created man in His image, and man is perfect as it is. But in a world where nothing but wrong is taught, and man takes on only sin, then man becomes man slowly becomes to deteriorate and destroy itself and be harmed, and man becomes slowly destructed by the wrongs he's confronted with. So slowly but surely we become breaking down, we become spiritually hurt, damaged, and susceptible, and thus vulnerable to all different sorts of discomforts and diseases and infirmities and insanities, so on and so forth. But Man in the image of his creator is whole. So the reason why we must understand, we must comprehend and overstand the reason for everything. So the word, the logos, the logic of the grounds upon judgment. Judgment being the result of the ground. So we must discover that which caused this judgment. So when concerning health, we'll give an example. Before we give an example, we'll make mention that any symptom is only but that, a symptom. It is not the actual infirmity or discomfort or disunity or division of the holy individual. The symptoms are just an effect of a certain cause that we must be able to discover and comprehend and interpret correctly in order for us to free ourselves from the burdens, the judgment of this disease, of this action which along with it entails responsibility. So now so basically what we're trying to say is that any medication is only but a medium to something that we already have direct access to. Any medication is only but a treatment. It'll never do anything but treat, but comfort the disease until your last breath. It's a treatment. They're going to treat a disease and keep that disease doing what it's done until you die, basically, in some cases, without it getting any worse. So that's definitely not what we are seeking. We should desire and seek the Most High. And if we do that, then we would overstand and comprehend the word and the interpretation thereof, and thus be able to rid ourselves of that discomfort. Now, when a weed grows, it grows and it comes out from the ground. And what one in a gardener does not appreciate that weed, one would cut the weed or even if you cut it from the point in which it actually grows above ground, there's still a root to that weed, and it'll keep growing and strengthening in time. We must be able to go to the root and take the whole problem out. So medication is it's not the solution. Now, we're not trying to promote the non-use of medication. You know, it's necessary to a certain extent, with the knowledge of knowing that it's only to treat these symptoms. Being that the situation has most likely gotten farther or has grown to an extent that the medication is probably necessary, but knowing that is only until one can truly comprehend or discover the significance or the correct interpretation of the grounds upon judgment. And so take your medication until you kind of actually figure it out. It's basically what we're trying to say. We're not trying to get ones off with their medication and stuff like that, but ones must be conscious and well aware that is not the cure. That's only going to give you some time while you actually figure out what the heck is taking place. So now, we kind of lost track, so we're just going to jump into the example. For example, let's say there is a young lady, and she begins to have shoulder pain. Now, she gets a massage, it doesn't work. She seems to have this pain, and it gets worse and worse and worse. So eventually, you know, she's prescribed some medication, takes it, nothing helps. Goes to the hospital, she gets operated on her shoulder, and it, you know, the pain's gone for a while, but eventually it comes back. Nowhere throughout this process did anyone ever just consider why. Why? What is the basis? What is the grounds? What is the foundation to this pain? You know, we're only taught to go to treat a symptom, but we're not taught to overcome the circumstance and overcome the situation by understanding and comprehending and correctly interpreting the grounds upon judgment. So now, we know that women love to flash their purses, and we know that women have been programmed to want the biggest bags known to humanity and carry those bags for the rest of their lives, right? And in many cases, women have various or a very large amount of bags, or a very different assortment of stylish bags that in some cases cost more than. We're not going to get into that. So we know that women love to carry their bags. There's exceptions, but you know, in speaking generally, women love to carry huge bags. But the human intellect, man's intellect, women and children, is even though we're at a point in where most individuals are borderline schizophrenic and just insane. Even in this situation where it's pretty bad, there's still something within man's intellect that does not allow you to go on carrying that bag simply vainly. You know, even if the next step you take to avoid this self-consciousness that's, you know, kind of like affecting your brain with the knowledge that it's not just right to carry a big bag, even if you take steps to fill it up with a bunch of junk or just nonsense, it's still somewhat of a function of a semi-functioning mind within the human that tells you that you just can't wear this big bag. At least put some stuff in there. So basically, we're trying to say that even though we're in a place and time in which people are completely crazy, there's still something within man that tells you at least put something in the bag if you're going to be carrying it around all day. So women eventually fill up their bags with a million different kinds of things that don't even matter, don't even serve any real purpose. But, you know, just for the sake of not carrying the bag in vain, well, completely in vain. So now these are big bags, and these bags can hold up to that. We're not sure, but by judging by the size of some, they might be able to hold various large amounts of pounds. We're not even going to estimate because, you know, we don't even know the quality or the manufacturing of the bags and how strengthened they are and stuff like that. But they, you know, judging from the sight of its size, it seems as if they can carry quite a bit of weight. So now women carry this every day, everywhere they go for the rest of their lives. And usually they pick a side, left or right. So in most cases, a female will go on carrying a bag, a huge bag, with huge amounts of weight on one side for the rest of their lives. Let's say that one of these ladies encounters a shoulder pain. Never ever throughout their existence will they be taught to think of the reason why it might be that their shoulder has been hurting and surgery has not worked and pills and medication and massages and therapy and all that kinds of stuff has not worked. Well, if we could just learn to realize that maybe, just maybe, it's the fact that I wear this huge bag full of weight that is causing this problem. It is as simple as figuring that out, interpreting the history correctly, and being able to discover the grounds to the judgment, which is the result of pain. One can go about in ways and forms as to how to treat not to treat, excuse me, how to, one can go about as to how to solve this discomfort. One thing would be you stop wearing the bags. And that's not even what we're trying to promote. You know, we've been given, as Our Majesty says, the gift of intellect and reason. You don't even have to stop wearing the bag. You could alternate sides. You could buy a smaller bag. You can carry less weight on the bag. You could only, you may be able to wear that bag in situations in which it is necessary to wear it, in situations or circumstances that will require you to actually benefit from the materials within that bag. You know, if we could learn how to come to these conclusions, that we can, then we can, only then can we eliminate all these repercussions or reactionary pains and discomforts and diseases. Now, this is a simple example, but it, you know, we hope it proves the point that if we can kind of like figure out these simple matters of comprehending and interpreting the history and the events leading up to the result, which is the pain or whatever, and finding out along the way what it was that caused something, if we can seek the Lord our God, the Word, if we can seek the reason, the logic behind everything, the rationale, then we can attain freedom. Because by knowing, we shall be set free. And whom the Son has freed is free indeed. So now, and best of all, it doesn't even require you to give up that which is, that which even initiated the problem. Like we said, there's many different solutions. Maybe you pick 2 days out of the week that you wear this purse or bag out of, as to before, 7 days a week, every single day, all day. You know, maybe you could, you know, you could drop the weight, you could buy a smaller bag, and or you could only just use it in necessary circumstances. There's so many different alternatives, but we're not taught to overcome a circumstance. We're only taught to be overshadowed, overpowered, and overstrengthened by circumstances and situations, so that we can depend on mediums or middlemen to just continue servicing, kind of holding up this pain or disease for the rest of your life, so that they could get paid and you can keep coming to them in hopes of recovery, basically is what we're trying to say. So that is our philosophy, we could say ideology, on this particular health reasoning. But it's well, but it's on good grounds, we would say.